Vibhas Sen, National Wheelchair Fencing Champion.
If your life is a book, and you are the author, what you have wanted are the best of everything, right? Through generations, there is a book which is passed from your grandfather to your father to you, the cycle of life. It has all the steps of what needs to be done at what stage of life. Diagnosed with polio, 3 months old, my version of the book changed. My book became suddenly irrelevant to me. So what I do? I started writing my own book, chapter by chapter, and I hoped that my book could be an inspiration to people like me. During the summers, when I was my sixth grade, I wanted to learn swimming, right? All my friends had enrolled for the swim class. I went up to the coach and asked him that I wanted to learn to swim. But he was not confident. He felt that because I couldn't walk and hence I couldn't swim. That was the very first thing in my life where I saw a rejection and I was shattered. But I didn't have much options back then, right? So life moved on. 15 years from that day, I was watching 2012 Paralympic Swimming Championship. I saw this guy, Tao Cheng, from a China, win a gold. He has no limbs, right? And that quickly made me realize some people back then challenged my ability. They defined what I could do and what I couldn't. So I thought, let's give a swimming and another attempt. So I contacted few swimming coaches and I shared my physical limitation and how eager I was learned to swim. So the coaches, 15 years from then, was way too advanced, right? So they quickly told me, sure, you can swim. Just come into the swimming pool the next day, right? And the same swimming pool which rejected me 15 years back, I was swimming in the same pool 15 years from that time, right? Yes, after swimming for 2 odd years, I got a lot of medals in states and national championship, right? This is the first medal I've got in my life which actually changed what people see in me. Before this medal, I was just a guy who was disabled. Suddenly, after my first medal, I was a guy who was called a sports person. That just a single medal changed the entire view on me. Right? So, 2 years of aggressive swimming, I quickly realized that I was not able to keep up with my age because I started at a very later stage of my life. So I had left with 2 options, right? One was that I either give up sports or I choose a sport which doesn't have any age bearing in it. And I chose the latter as always. So for the next 4 years, I started training for fencing, which is one of the most unorthodox sports in India. I mean, this was a small trailer of how fencing is played, actually in a wheelchair, right? So yes, for the next 4 years, I was actually representing India at a national and international level. I have played various international tournament from Asian Championship to World Championship, representing India continuously. But that was not the end. Because of fencing, God opened too many doors for me. I was suddenly talking to schools and colleges, giving motivation sessions. I actually realized that I have got an opportunity where I can talk of something which is more valuable, that is to share the plight which we have in sports in India and about accessibility, the main reason where people with disability are not given that opportunity to play the sport. Fencing became my visa. I visited countries like US, Hong Kong, Poland multiple times. I was traveling the world. It opened doors that I never imagined it would have. I tried many different sports which was not available in India. Skiing, wheelchair basketball, scuba, ice hockey. I became the first person from India to be selected for a exchange program in United States for sport diplomacy. I actually realized that sport can be used as not only as a recreational activity, but we can also use sport to give, to make a change in the world using sport diplomacy. We can actually try and change policy. I can actually go and talk that why this infrastructure needs change. I was actually not a sports person. I was driving change because of my sports, because what sports gave me. When I meet some people in some restaurants or some or in a private establishment, I always ask them, why isn't this place accessible? They always come up with a standard reply saying, ki there are hardly any people with disability who actually come and visit their places. And I quickly reply them saying, the reason you don't have people with disability visiting you because your place is not accessible, right? So they quickly change their statement and say, for 15% of people, you want me to change my entire infrastructure? I say no. It's actually the 100% people. People age, people go old, people would need assistance 20, 30, 40 years down the line. So you have to make places accessible for everyone. So I am here asking all my fellow friends, colleagues, that please try and ask people around, you know, to make places accessible, right? And make sure that just a single request can actually bring a change. We all have that power of bringing a change. And I would like to end this with a small quote by Denzel Washington. It's not how much you have, it's what you do with what you have. So thank you.